It's exciting and it's kind of amazing to watch what's happened with private industry getting into the space business in such a big way and partnering with the government. Why don't you tell us a little bit first about this project to work on a commercial space station? How does that work? Is there government support for this? How are all the pieces kind of put together?
Thanks. Yeah, it's fascinating to see the evolution of the sector. We've had government supporting the growth of it with starting with the Crew Dragon for SpaceX, and or starting with cargo rather, then having Crew, which we see today, and then allowing for private missions to the station. But as we know, the International Space Station is reaching its end of life and it needs to be replaced. So Axiom Space will be building the world's first commercial space station to take over as the only destination in space by building modules for the new space station on top of the existing space station. So it's a modular bit by piece by piece that it will be built. And once the new station exists, they will deorbit. The government has supported this with funding, and Axiom Space has completed its own more recent funding round, which is quite exciting, of raising $130 million and having private astronauts secured for their first mission to the space station, where they will host astronauts on the existing International Space Station for 10-day missions.
Wow. You know, Lisa, the reason this has always been in the realm of the government before is they were the only ones who ever had enough money. And the government has still put a lot of money to bear on this. I know for Crew Dragon, NASA gave SpaceX $3.1 billion for the Crew Dragon in those first six missions. How much are they giving for the space station, and how much needs to be raised privately?
Right. Well, what's the financial model starts with the ability to train astronauts and have private astronauts in the space station. So selling the seats for $55 million a ticket is helpful in that regard. And as we see the development in stages, it becomes more manageable. But in terms of the dollars, there's the Commercial Lunar Payload Services Program. That's a $2.6 billion program over the next 10 years. And we've seen companies benefiting from that for the landers so far that we're planning to have on the moon. So that's helpful. And then they're having a $400 million program they just announced recently to have what we call free flyers, which would be other space platforms to have other destinations in space. So all of this support helps with the space economy. And what we're seeing today, the consistency of starting with the SpaceX launches and then having the cargo delivered to the ISS, what you're seeing is consistency and reliability and reusability. And all of these things are factors for building what I would say are the roads and bridges to space, for commercial space. The government wants to buy services. And so if you can buy the service of resupply missions to the space station, if you can buy the service of sending astronauts to the space station and then sending an orbital mission to the moon, which they will do with starships, this is the opening up access to space.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.